The Philippines and Japan set to sign today, July 8, their reciprocal access agreement that would allow troops of the two countries to operate and train together. The RAA is close to, but not exactly like, the Visiting Forces Agreement of Manila with Washington. Once the deal is in place, Japanese troops would be able to participate in military exercises in the Philippines. The agreement will also cover issues on custody and handling of visiting service members who break the law. After the signing, the treaty will need to be ratified by the legislative bodies of the two countries before it comes into force. Meanwhile, progressive groups warning against entering into the deal, saying it will worsen tensions with China. The groups are expected to flock to the Japanese embassy today in protest of the signing of the RAA. The provincial government of Bulacan bans the establishment of POGOs. Governor Daniel Fernando says, as it stands, there are no POGOs in Bulacan, but he wants to make sure they won't be able to enter the province. He adds he wants the province to be spared from the criminal activities related to POGOs, especially human trafficking.
Ginawa natin to, syempre, unang-una ay parang papatektahan natin ang ating lalawigan tungkol sa mga nangyayari. Ano po? At alam naman natin, may mga nangyayari na rito hindi na maganda sa likod ng POGO. Ngayon pa lang, siyempre, agapan na natin. That's why nag-issue tayo ng executive order for monitoring all the local chief executive, the barangay, the mayors, ano po, at kinakailang magbigay sila sa akin ng report within that 10 days.
Governor Fernando also believes banning POGOs will have little to no impact to Bulacan's local economy.
Dati namang wala namang ang POGO ang Bulacan, nakaka-survive naman. Yung maayos ang ating ekonomiya. Totoo lang, hindi naman din nakapagbibigay ito ng hanap buhay. Dati mga kababayan, dahil karamihan dito yung mga Chinese national, ang mga nagiging laborer dito.
An indoor firing range and an underground tunnel discovered in a residential compound in Porac, Pampanga. Authorities on Saturday searched the facilities, which are suspected to be used by Chinese nationals overseeing illegal POGOs in Bamban and Porac. The compound is also located less than 5 kilometers from the raided Lucky South 99. Torture devices and incriminating documents also discovered in the area. One of the alleged owners of the compound is also linked to the brother of suspended Bamban Mayor Alice Go.
Nahuling POGO dyan sa Lucky South 99 is yung mga allegedly mga top brass, yung mga officers nila dyan is doon umuwi sa tinatawag lang POGO leisure hub na ito sa Barangay Senyora. Basta yung mga subject ng search warrant like mga hazing parapernalia, meron silang handcuff, baseball bat. Hinold natin ang mga occupants, nasa station siya for questioning, and yung dalawa na incorporators sa whirlwind. So nandun din sa loob.
Let's now get an update on the weather from PAGASA forecaster Veronica Torres. Good morning, Veronica.
Good morning, Ms. Bethina, and to all of our audience in ENC. Currently, easterlies is affecting the eastern sections of Luzon and Visayas, and we're expecting partly cloudy to cloudy skies with chances of localized thunderstorms over Metro Manila and the rest of the country. We don't have any gale warning raised over any parts of the country, and we're not monitoring any low pressure area or tropical cyclone near or inside the Philippine area of responsibility. And that's the latest from PAGASA Weather Forecasting Center, Veronica C. Torres reporting.
Thank you very much for that update. Heading now to France, where the far right suffers a huge blow in the country's legislative runoff election. Projections show the national rally coming in third spot behind the new Popular Front left-wing coalition and President Emmanuel Macron's centrist camp. This despite the RN leading polls in the build-up to Sunday's vote. The election will leave the French parliament divided in three big groups, the left, centrist, and the far right, with hugely different platforms and no tradition of working together.
We The quagmire that I warned about has of course come true. France will be totally blocked with three groups that have more or less the same influence in the National Assembly. We're going towards that, it said. We're losing one more year of unregulated immigration, one more year of losing purchasing power, and one more year of a blowing up of insecurity in our country.
The vote is also a blow for Macron, who called for a snap election after his ticket was trounced in the European Parliament elections last month. French Prime Minister Gabriel Attal says he will be handing in his resignation Monday.
I know that in light of the results tonight, many French people feel a form of uncertainty over the future, because no absolute majority has come out of it. Our country is experiencing an unprecedented political situation and is preparing to welcome the world for the Olympics in a couple of weeks. That said, I will, of course, do my duties as long as it's needed.
Meanwhile, thousands gathered in Paris to denounce the far right and celebrate the results of the second round of elections. Protesters clapped, chanted slogans, and set off fireworks at the Place de la République. The far right was undone to a large extent by tactical deal-making between centrist and leftist opponents, who pulled more than 200 candidates from three-way races to avoid splitting the anti-RN vote. The projected result brought to a halt what had appeared to be the far right's relentless rise in France. Over in the U.S., President Joe Biden is back on the campaign trail as he faces growing pressure from fellow Democrats worried about his candidacy. Biden again visited the battleground state of Pennsylvania to rally both his supporters and campaign workers. Sunday's stop was Biden's 10th trip to Pennsylvania during the 2024 election cycle.
We're drawing crowds that have been really big crowds ever since the debate, not joking. Even that night in the debate, we had great crowds afterwards. And so things are moving. They're moving hard. And look, the other thing is that people want to know you care. They want to know we care. There's nothing letting someone know you care like knocking on the door and saying, my name's so-and-so, I'm here for Joe Biden. Is there anything? What do you need? Pennsylvania is a critically important state. Critically important state. And so I'm counting on you.
Pennsylvania Senator John Fetterman also giving his seal of approval to Biden.
There is only one person in this room that kicked Trump's ass in an election. There is only one person in this state that has kicked Trump's ass in an election. There is only one person in the country that's ever kicked Trump's ass in an election, and that is your president.
Biden also made a stop at a black church in Philadelphia. Black voters are a critical part of Biden's base of support, and recent public opinion polling has shown their support for him softening. Biden is campaigning under an increasingly unforgiving spotlight after his debate with rival Donald Trump ignited panic over his age and fitness to serve another 4 years. U.S. Vice President Kamala Harris also going on the offensive. Speaking at an event in New Orleans, Harris attacked former U.S. President Donald Trump and the Supreme Court for taking away abortion rights. Her appearance was part of an effort by the Biden campaign to shore up support among black voters.
I think we all believe and know one does not have to abandon their faith and deeply held beliefs to agree the government should not be telling her what to do with her body. Understand that the former president, who is up for re-election, has said he is proud of what has happened, proud of the fact that our daughters will have fewer rights than their grandmothers.
Harris is the top choice to replace U.S. President Joe Biden if he were to step down as the Democratic Party's standard-bearer. protests are held across Israel to mark the 9 months since the October 7 attack, which triggered the Gaza War. Protesters called for the government to resign and for the release of hostages still held by Hamas. The demonstrators blocked roads and picketed the homes of government officials, including the Jerusalem residence of Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu. Efforts to secure a hostage deal between Israel and Hamas have gained momentum in recent days, with officials expressing optimism but saying gaps remain between the sides. Texas residents bracing for a tropical storm Beryl, which is expected to strengthen back into a hurricane before hitting the state early Monday. The storm, which at one point intensified into a Category 5, left a deadly trail of destruction across the Caribbean. It could grow into a Category 1 or 2 hurricane before it makes landfall in the middle of the Texas coast. Ports along the coast are closing or restricting traffic, which could bring a temporary halt to crude exports. Let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now from our Bureau Chief, DJ Manotok.
Good morning to friends of the Rundown. I'm DJ Manotok with your headlines from the North American region.
We begin in San Francisco, where the suspect in the deadly train attack of 74-year-old Filipina Corazon Dandan is scheduled to be arraigned on Friday afternoon. The San Francisco District Attorney's Office has charged 49-year-old Trevor Belmont, also known as Hawk Tyne, with one count of murder. He is also accused of inflicting great bodily injury on a vulnerable person and allegedly intentionally killed Dandan while lying in wait. On Monday around 11 p.m., Dandan was coming home from her shift as a telephone operator at a hotel and was standing on the platform at the Powell Street BART station when she was allegedly pushed into the path of a Millbrae-bound train by Belmont, who is described as transient or homeless. Kyle Dandan told ABS-CBN News that his Tita Coring was a loving and supportive aunt.
She always treated us as her own kids. When I went to the States for college, it was more of like helping me get my own car, paying for my cell phone bills when I was still a student. They didn't disclose yet the motive of the suspect, but there are signs of being mentally disturbed.
Meanwhile, the Vancouver Committee for Domestic Workers and Caregivers' Rights was in a jubilant mood as the country celebrated the 157th Canada Day on July 1st. For the caregivers and pioneers who led the fight, this year's Canada Day is especially memorable.
After 45 years of calling for landed status now upon arrival, after 8 years of walk for landed status now, we finally got the government government's recognition that yes, domestic workers and care workers deserve permanent resident status upon arrival.
Senen Bagon is among the pioneers who have been fighting for permanent resident status for caregivers upon arrival since 1979. They were joined later by Angie Olao, who came to Canada as a temporary domestic worker in 1981.
I'm really very happy that the progress, although very slow, that domestic workers now has better opportunities than we did before. They don't have to fight for it because we planted the seeds for domestic workers.
And those are the top stories making the headlines in the North American region. You can catch more of our TFC News on our ABS-CBN News website and YouTube channel. I'm TJ Manalto. Back to our friends at the Rundown.